It might not exactly be breaking news that summer is hot, but the last few months have been some of the hottest and driest on record for a number of regions. To break down the numbers, MetService meteorologist Georgina Griffiths joins us now. Good morning.
Morena, how are you?
So, very good, thank you. So, is it just hot and we like to complain, or are we actually breaking records?
No, we're breaking records, and that's why we wanted to come and have a chat, put this drought for the upper north into context. A really significant record-breaking driest summer. So driest or second driest on record for Northland, Auckland, Coromandel, Waikato, even Western Bay aplenty. So, yeah, I mean, the farmers know it and people who live up here, particularly those on tank, we all knew this was a significant drought, but the numbers help put that into context, just how severe it's been.
So when you say it's the driest or second driest on record, how long have records been going for?
Yeah, we're not just talking the short ones this time too. So Whangarei, our second driest in records, that began in 1937, and it's really only playing number two to that killer drought in 1945-46, which was a really terrible drought for the Upper North Island. And
wow.
Hamilton Ruakura record 1905, driest on record. Now that's a really notable record for the Waikato, of course, and obviously cockies down there will be knowing it. Western Bay aplenty, second driest on record, and a record that started in 1898. 122
wow.
years of record. So very significant summer dry.
Do we look to those droughts and those records to see what we might expect up here now?
Yeah, I mean, just to put it in context, to clarify, we didn't have the heat that we have now in the summer of 1945-46. The war drought, were very significant for the Upper North Island, caused by a big fat high that sat around rather like this one, and we just didn't have that heat. And really important to note, 2019 was very dry for the Upper North Island. So we're actually, it's been 15 months of dry up here.
So it's compounding.
Yeah, and so it's not just been summer, it's actually been the driest January to July last year. We didn't get the spring rains we needed, then it went dry before Christmas again. So we're doing it hard up here.
So when are we expecting some relief?
Yeah, I mean, that's the other reason I wanted to come on, is to give a little bit of hope to those people trying to cope with the lack of rain. You can almost smell the rain at the moment in Auckland, Northland, those easterlies and that humidity really starting to climb now. We do see a small burst of rain on Wednesday for the drought-stricken north. Useful rain, about the same as we got about 10 days ago with that first rain band we'd seen for quite some time. It was lovely. About the same again, so it's not enough to break the drought. But it is useful rain, and what we want is that the good news is that it's finally started to break the high, that absolute power of that high.
Right.
Started to break down and allow that front through. And we will start to see more of those rain bands coming through as March progresses. So good news this week, high returns next week. After that, we need some more of these rain bands starting to come on.
So I'm a little bit up north, but north of Auckland at the moment, and you see these clouds and they look dark and you can smell the rain and it feels like rain. But it doesn't rain.
No, we're just getting sprinkles at the moment. Today, yesterday, just a odd sprinkle or a spit on the windscreen. That's not what I'm talking about. We actually need the feature on Wednesday to come through up here and actually make it rain, because it's very humid. So you do need something to help squeeze out the moisture.
Right, so it's there, but it's just,
yeah,
it's
so
just
staying there. Out on that Wednesday rainfall. It's a little bit unreliable about how much your place will get. Mm-hmm. 20 millimetres if you're lucky, more like 15 for most of us, but we'll take it.
We will take it. What's behind this persistent high?
Now that's the Southern Ocean thing, actually, Hayley. We have been driven by the Southern Ocean being in its quiet spell and allowing the highs to sit here, okay? And that is what they do when the Southern Ocean is quiet. You know, some winters and springs we get stormy Southern Ocean, those storm fronts and rain bands wash up and over New Zealand. That's not what it looks like at the moment.
It's not, is it? This is, I mean, we say this, we ask this every single time, is this the new reality?
Well, it is under climate change, because a quiet Southern Ocean or persistent high over New Zealand is part of the recipe of a warmer world. We will be having longer and more persistent droughts because of more highs in the New Zealand region. So that is a climate change signal. We know this. People way more cleverer than me have done a lot of research around that. So that is something we can say, expect more drought in the future.
So we need to plan for it.
We do.
Thank you so much, Georgina Griffiths from MetService.
Thank you.